sampai jadi hari-hari bikin jam pertama kali. Aku buat lagi, salah lagi tak jadi tak sampai jadi.
My name is Hafizuddin Syahmi, 22 years old, and I am from Batu Gajah, Perak, and the owner of Project Illegal. Today, I want to talk about how did this Project Illegal come about. Believe it or not, back then Project Illegal was originally a graphic design studio, whose original name I don't want to say for some reason, so I will name it as Boyx Studio. Boyx Studio is an idea from our friend. We are a group of 6 people. He said he wants to establish a graphic design studio that provides teaching and software tutorials such as Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, Adobe Premiere Pro, and so on. In addition, he wants to use a platform like YouTube to create animation and creative work video, then generate income from the monetization. That idea seems hard and quite impossible, because Malaysia seems like it is not yet famous for such content, and it will be difficult to generate income. So this is where I expressed the idea to establish jersey and sublimation production to support the startup of Boyx Studio. Because by making jersey, you can generate more income and quickly. So the plan is to gain some income from the jersey production and use the income to set up Boyx Studio. So I use the same name for our jersey company, Boyx Apparel, not the real name. So why Project Illegal? Remember the story earlier that we at Boyx Apparel have split up, and I still want to continue this project of shirts and jersey. But I don't want to use the name Boyx Apparel, because later it will be related to Boyx Studio. So, I managed to invite my 3 friends from earlier to do it together. But we have ordered packaging, hang tags and many other items using the name Boyx Apparel. So, we had to contact the supplier again to make amendments, but the business card supplier said they had started printing and could not change. So, we lost there. The good news is that the packaging supplier said it is still possible to change because the printing process has not started, and at their discretion, we are only given 6 hours to send the new design. So in these 6 hours, we had to do everything back, find a name, redesign, and send a new design. Thinking of a new name, my friend said, why don't we put Project Illegal? Because we have to do all this quickly and it seems impossible. And finally, we managed to finish it in the given time. We suddenly split up because we did not understand each other. We had to do this and that. The situation was a mess. That's why we agreed on the name Project Illegal. So that's where the name Project Illegal comes from and how it was established. Project Illegal has been established for almost a year and has produced over 1,000 shirts for our customers, which is, for me, it is something I can be proud of. So that's all from me, how did Project Illegal was established. So stay tuned for the next episode. Thank you.